Hi everyone, welcome to acads.ai. First of all, I would like to thank you all for the overwhelming response that we've received on our course on SEBI. So this video is going to be very crucial as this video is more like a demand from our learners. So this is a response to all the mails that we've been receiving overwhelmingly over the past few days about how to prepare for RBI and SEBI. Thus, in this video, we shall be covering the integrated prep for RBI and SEBI exams. And also we shall take up the related concerns and issues. We will also try to bust a few myths at the end of the video, so stay tuned. First things first, please maintain social distancing, maintain a distance of at least 6 feet and stay safe. My advice for coping is the same for all scary events and possibilities that life brings to you. Go for the facts, even the most difficult ones, because anxiety escalates and fantasies flourish in the absence of data. So data is what you need in life and facts should be the approach to go to. And more importantly, please do not die. Please be alive. This is a time when you can be a hero by simply staying at home. So make the best use of this time. What this video is going to be about? So first of all, due to recent changes, like there is a delay in the exam for SEBI, you know, the exam has been delayed by almost 2 months. Then there is a syllabus revamp of SEBI, the most unexpected thing that could have happened. Also, RBI is approaching. Then there is Corona lockdown and everything. Thus, there is a need of integrated preparation for RBI and SEBI. Also, we should know that how can we utilize these 21 days that we have at our perusal to our full potential. Then we have certain preparation tips from teams from acads.ai teams. Also, we shall give you an insight into who we are and why we are here. Next up is who should watch this video. For us, there is no greater sin than to waste an aspirant's even single minute of the time. Thus, our strategy videos are usually compact, as you must have already seen. And our aim is not to monetize on our YouTube channel by posting long videos for our learners. Thus, I will be very to the point and crisp. So this video is for, of course, RBI and SEBI aspirants. Then there are another three categories that we have in front of here. This video is for those who value their time, like working professionals who right now are staying and working at home. Then we have other people who are preparing for some other competitive exams, be it any other banking exam, or say you're preparing for UPSC. And aspirants who haven't yet finished their RBI or SEBI syllabus. So if you're not amongst these video, amongst any of these categories, please do not waste your time and go study. Let me give you an insight about two of our team members. So Funny is one of the senior members of the team. Funny, as you can see from his profile, is an ideal Sharma ji ka beta. So he cracked JEE in his very first attempt with All India rank 30. And he did his graduation in CS. And then he again had one of the best jobs in IIT-B placements. In the same year, he prepared for CAT and cleared all the major IIMs. Then finally, he got admitted into IIM-A. There, he secured the kind of job that you read about in newspapers, a 1 crore plus package. He worked in the US, then in the Hong Kong, and ultimately decided to come back to India to start and successfully incubate a startup. That was his calling. He has done CFA, FRM, and he possesses extensive knowledge of finance and management, which is not just theoretical. Believe me, it's practical knowledge. Then we have Gaurav. Gaurav is a recent joinee to our team. Gaurav prefers calling himself an entrepreneur. So he loves challenges. There is an interesting fact about Gaurav. He found a loophole in the IIT-B rule book while he was in college and completed his graduation in just 3 years. Since it was not really allowed, he just took courses for the sake of formality in his last year. When he was doing the double course load in third year, he secured a 9+ CPI. He believes that the busier you are, higher is the productivity. So just to challenge himself, he decided to attempt all exams at once in his last year. He went for CAT, GATE, UPSC and whatnot. Don't be shocked. Here is one more fact about him. His graduation was in aerospace and he attempted GATE in physics. Then he gave quant for QRE and he gave UPSC with PABAD and maths as optionals. And so basically he did not take any of the subjects of his graduation. Also, apart from being an engineer, he has a commerce mindset and he likes to read law books, companies law and CA books in his free time. There are many such funnies and Gaurav's in the team. Why ACADS is here? So when we started ACADS, we were looking up to tie up with a few RBI and SEBI institutes to actually take forward the preparation and the scenario. But we couldn't really find institutes of which provided quality education and quality guidance. Thus, expansion into RBI and SEBI was not out of choice, but rather more of a compulsion because of the dearth of quality resources available in the market. And the current ecosystem of these coaching institutes are unnecessarily complicating the prep. Thus, ACADS started due to lack of quality guidance and credible faculty, and we saw the need as well as the opportunity for compact learning. Here are some of our mantras that we must be knowing. Less is always more. So we always believe that study less, take up less of things, but revise them multiple times to be very coherent. Compact but comprehensive. Be compact in your notes, be compact in your prep, but be very comprehensive, having a wholesome understanding. Do not leave behind any stones unturned. Study smart and not hard. Everybody, believe us, can study hard. It's the art of smartness that takes you higher. Always value an aspirant's time, as you saw in the very beginning of the video. And transparency. I shall be taking up transparency at the end of the video through an example, how we are always transparent in our conduct and our communication with our learners. So why the integrated preparation for RBI and SEBI? A few of the events which unfolded actually led to an integrated preparation for RBI and SEBI. So first of all, they have a lot of common syllabus. This is especially after SEBI entirely revamped its syllabus. So there is a lot of overlap that is happening. Then there is high probability of overlapping of exam cycles. I'm not saying that the exams will happen at the same time, but SEBI, as you know, has already been postponed by 2 months. So it will be starting its cycle in July and it will continue till about September, you can say, the interviews and everything. At the same time, we are expecting the RBI notification to be out. So there is a very high probability that the exam cycles and all will overlap. These are also two of the most prestigious public sector jobs, also high paying. And let me tell you, these are one of the most underrated jobs, as I can see, in comparison to other jobs like UPSC, which comprises of IAS, IPS, IRS. So these are really underrated and hence the preparation is also not up to the mark. Also, never put all your eggs in one basket. People might tell you otherwise. People might tell you that focus on one thing at a time. But believe me, this is not going to end up and let you end up anywhere, because you need to diversify your risk, especially in these uncertain times when exams are being postponed and the syllabuses are changing every year. The competition is increasing. You cannot rely on one thing to succeed in life. You need to have a backup ready. You need to be prepared for everything wrong that can happen. So let's see what is the common syllabus of RBI and SEBI. So phase one is actually entirely common: quant, reasoning and English, and general awareness. But phase one for SEBI is relatively easier to crack because there is just an overall cap of 40% that you have to score. However, for RBI, most chunk of the competition actually gets screened only in phase one. Thus, for RBI, phase one is more of a challenge rather than for SEBI. Also, for SEBI, there is paper one and paper two in phase one. So paper one is same as phase one of RBI, and paper two is same as phase two. So basically, the phase two of SEBI, paper two of SEBI also contains topics called like finance, management, some portions of economy, and English. This is overlapping with RBI. Next, we have the extra mile that you have to go for RBI. So what is the extra thing that you have to learn for RBI? So as I told you earlier, phase one is the difficult part of RBI phase one. And it needs dedicated preparation apart from preparing for phase two. Also, general awareness here is the key to success. It can really make or break your chances because there is an 80 marks of GA that you get. Thus, it really has a big role in making you cross the phase one mark. Also, QRE cannot be ignored because there is, you need to score above average marks because there is sectional cutoff. There was sectional cutoff last year. So basically, you cannot ignore QRE as well. Thus, phase 1 is the real challenge. In phase 2, apart from the overlapping syllabus that we saw, there are other things like social issues, finance, mein there is risk management, corporate governance, and then FM questions are expected to be more analytical. However, the 2019 paper was a little bit easier. But again, these I would say are more like an artificial compartmentalization, because ultimately all of these things you will have to study, if not much in detail, but to some extent for SEBI as well. So not much of a difference here. Also, FM, you cannot be really sure if it is going to be analytical or more theoretical. You have to be prepared for the worst. Then let's see what's the extra syllabus for SEBI. So if I draw a Venn diagram, So this is say RBI and this is SEBI, and this is the overlap that is happening. So this is the extra mile that you have to go for RBI. On the other hand, for SEBI it is this much. So basically you see the difference here. The phase 2 contains a lot of topics which are a lot of standalone, not just topics I would say, but subjects that you have to study in detail for SEBI for phase 2. These are costing, commerce and accounting, microeconomics and companies act. So the syllabus is a lot more there in phase 2. On the other hand, phase 1 is relatively easier to clear, because in paper 1 you just need to score 30% marks, and paper 2 40% marks, and in aggregate you need to score just 40% to clear the final exam, that is 80 out of 200 marks, which is not a very difficult task, to be very honest. So what is going to be the plan of action for you? So these 21 days that you have for yourself are rather very crucial. Let's break down the timeline. So if we take March 25 to April 30, why I'm taking April 30 is that let's face the reality, there is a high chance that the lockdown might get extended. Or even if it doesn't, hopefully it doesn't get extended, then too it takes a few days for things to come back on track and for things to get normal. So you can comfortably take a window of March 25 to April 30 for yourself. So in these 35 days, you should ideally be studying for 250 hours. This is very comfortably, this can be very comfortably given by working professionals and also students who are at home. And in these 250 hours, try to finish all the static portion of RBI and SEBI, both overlapping and the standalone topics. So things like finance, management, economy, social issues, commerce and accountancy, costing, companies, law. This should be the first thing that you complete, because no matter when the notification is out, you need to have a one-time reading done and one-time preparation done of these subjects. Then moving on, come to the second cycle, April 30 to June 10. Now these are again give another 250 hours during this time, and during these 20 days you need to have a thorough revision done of QRE and static GA. So basically revise everything that you have already learned, then do QRE and static GA. This is very important to clear RBI exam, as I already told you, because QRE plays a very important role in phase 1 for RBI exam. Then for RBI GA, everybody has this constant question that what is to be done for RBI GA. Though GA does not really form a very important part for SEBI, because it's only for 20 marks, 25 marks I think, and usme bhi static aur current mein bifurcation ho jata hai. So for SEBI it is not, you can comfortably ignore it, but for RBI it's for 80 marks. So 80 marks ke liye just go for the ACADS marks up GA capsule that you shall be receiving. Please do not go for bulky compilations of 100 pages a month, because it will only end up wasting your time and you will not be able to remember anything. We shall give you a 50 to 60 page capsule which shall cover all the current affairs of the past 6 months, just 50-60 pages for the past 6 months in all, to cover every important event and every important aspect of current GA that you need to score for RBI GA capsule. Also, you shall find the samples of last year's GA capsule, whereby we had about 70 on 80 questions in RBI phase 1 a lot of our learners, mostly most of them scored above 60 marks comfortably, and a lot of them came up with a scorecard saying that they scored about 75. So this is all you have to do for RBI GA. Then let me try to bust a myth here. I told you in the beginning where we shall try to bust a myth, bust a few myths here. We keep on getting these people have been overwhelmingly happy with our quality, and we keep on getting such queries like, in spite of being a team of such high quality, providing such high quality content and giving so much time and effort in making these courses, how are we managing to offer courses at such low prices when other institutes are offering at 2x the prices? So you see RBI ka courses for 20k, then SEBI ka another 20k, but it's not like that for us. So let me try to tell you why is that so. So first of all, we are a well-funded startup. I really hope our investors are not watching this. So what we believe is, we believe in enriching the quality of our course, right now we are not trying to monetize anything out of it, and then let it speak for itself. So our course should speak for itself. Then in the initial stage, we need data to make our AI product better, because our vision is to use AI to make you exam ready in the most efficient manner. Our AI algorithm needs data as fuel to make great educational models. Thus, your data feeds our AI model. Don't worry, we de-identify to maintain privacy. Then, our team consists of passionate educators who value teaching more than money. And they have cracked all the possible exams in the world themselves, so they know what learners want. Also, we rarely offer discounts, as you must have seen. We do not believe in charging very high markup prices on our website and then giving any discounts. Low prices are compensated by high volumes of sales that we have, so that's how our business model works. And we do not spend on marketing and rather rely on word of mouth for publicity. Thus, our main cost is just our team cost and the content making cost. How can you optimize these 21 days? So these 21 days, though we are in times of stark uncertainty, let me tell you, these 21 days are the most productive, predictable days of your life. I am not saying productive because only you can make it productive. These are really predictable. There are no variables in your life at this time. No friends are going to come up to take you anywhere. There's not going to be any office work or anything. You can plan the entire day, entire 24 hours to your convenience. You have enough time to complete 70 to 80% of the static syllabus, and that is what is needed to clear the exam. However, keeping yourself busy is the best way to optimize your efficiency, because these 24 hours can also go to your disadvantage, whereby you might waste time instead of not being able to plan it. So keeping yourself busy is really important. Also, as I told you, Gaurav believes the busier you are, higher is your productivity. So believe in that mantra, it really works wonders. What do we have to offer for you? So we bring to you ACADS Rebi. Sorry, I apologize, you could not come up with a better name for RBI plus SEBI, but time is of very high importance right now. So Rebi, it is available at rebi.acads.ai. What do we have to offer? It is compact but comprehensive in every respect possible. We follow a fixed schedule. Why we follow a fixed schedule? In scientific terms, it is just to decrease your degree of freedom. Thus, a fixed schedule will ensure learning optimization and higher retention. The team, we can say it with confidence that we have the best team, period. And integrated. There is going to be no repetition of content. There is going to be a good balance of factual and conceptual content. Also, you will not find any overlapping content. Whatever is overlapping shall be found at one place only. We do not want to unnecessarily make our course lengthy by showing overlapping things. So it is going to be a very integrated course. As per Gaurav, if IQ would have been the decided factor, he would have failed his 12th. Thus, clearing an exam is not about knowledge. Rather, it is about knowing how to score marks. And you can learn that with us through the right strategy, guidance, and dedicated prep. Believe me, I speak on behalf of our entire team who have always done the unthinkable. If they can, so can you. And one more thing, there are always going to be naysayers. So just a heads up. How can you join? Please log on to acads.ai. You can also check out our samples on Telegram or YouTube. And you can always ping us on Telegram, WhatsApp or mail us. We're always available. Happy to help. Thank you.